In this video, I will show you how to create an interactive map such as this one in about 5 minutes. The name of the software is StatPlanet, so if you head over to Google and type StatPlanet, you will find the website among the first few links. You can see it over here. And I'm going to head straight over to the download section. So there are several downloads available. To create your own maps, you need to download MapMaker. You can see over here. And this is a zip file, which means I need to extract the contents of the zip onto my computer. So I'm just going to grab the folder and drag it and drop it somewhere onto my computer. This is a folder on my desktop. So let's have a look at the contents of the StatPlanet MapMaker folder. See here, it contains 3 subfolders. There is a docs folder which contains the user guide. There is a custom map folder which contains the software for creating your own maps. For example, there's a Flash template which you can edit in Adobe Flash to create your own maps. And there's the world map folder which you'll be looking at in this video. And it contains 3 files, you see here. There is the data file, and this contains the data which is read by StatPlanet and displayed inside the map. You can edit this file using any kind of spreadsheet software. Then there's the StatPlanet data editor, and this one needs to be opened in Microsoft Excel. This is the one we'll be using. I'm going to click on that, and you can see it opening inside Excel here. Now the first thing you need to do is to enable the macros contained in the data editor. So you should probably see either a pop-up window if you're using an older version of Excel, or a message as you can see here, a newer version of Excel. And this indicates that the macros have been disabled. So what you need to do is enable them. So I'm going to click this options button over here and enable this content and press OK. So now the macros have been enabled. What this means is that I can now use the 4 buttons which you can see here at the top of the data editor. The first button is clear data. If I click on this button, it will empty all the example data which comes with the data editor. So I'm going to click on that, and you can see now the data has been removed. The second button allows you to import data from another file, so I'm going to click on that, and now I can look for a file on my computer and import it. So this should you can select basically any kind of data file. It can import any kind of data structure as long as there's country data inside it, and it has been tested with lots of different data files from many different organizations. And for this example, I will import some data from the World Health Organization. You can see here the 6 different files which have been downloaded from the website. In most cases, you don't have to modify the file at all. You can just import it straight away using the data editor. So I'm going to import some data on health expenditure. This might take a few seconds. And here you can see the result. So you can see the data has been structured. It has been organized according to year. Here's the year in the first column in descending order. And it found 4 different indicators in the file. And these 4 indicators are repeated for each of the years. If you scroll to the right, you can see the country data associated with these indicators. So this is a slightly more complicated example. In your case, you might only have data for 1 indicator or for 1 year, or you might have data which is not associated with any kind of year, and that is okay as well. So now to save the data, I need to press the 3rd button over here, save data, and this will save it as a comma separated values file. It will save it as data.csv. That is the file over here which was mentioned earlier. So this file has now been updated, and now I can run the application. So I'm going to click on Stat Planet, and now the data we have just imported is displayed in this interactive map. In the top left corner, you can see the four different indicators which were imported, and I can just click on one of the indicators and the map will automatically update. You can see the map legend in the bottom left corner, so the darker colors reflect higher values, the lighter colors reflect lower values, and these values can be changed. You can also click on one of the colors, and here you can see the various color schemes which come with the StatPlanet software, and you can very easily change the color scheme. These color schemes can also be set inside the data file. In the bottom you can see a time slider. Since I imported data from several different years, it'll show a time slider which allows you to go to a different year and also play all the years as an animation. In the top you see the graph window, and it has quite a few options for customization. I'll just look at a few of them right now. You can see the different options for changing the graph type here. For example, this is a bar chart. This is a time series graph. Here I can select a country on the world map and it will appear. Or I can also select the same country in the country list in the top right corner over here. Now I can also zoom into a particular map region. In the top left corner you can see a region selection option, and you can define these regions yourself. These are the ones that come standard in the data editor. One of them is Africa, so I can just click on that and zoom into Africa, and you can see now the data is also displayed on the map. So once again I can just click on one of the countries to display in the time series graph. If I want to enlarge this graph, there's a full screen button over here. If I click on that, you can now see the graph in a full screen view. One other graph type is a scatter plot. You can see the button over there, and it allows me to compare two different indicators, as you can see here. So that is the main functionality of the software. If you want to publish the map online, you need to go to the web folder. You can see it over here, and this contains the files you need to copy onto your website. So you can see one of the files is data. This is actually an exact copy of the data file in the main folder. So when you press the save button in the data editor, it saves a copy of data here and another copy of data inside the web folder. So this makes it very easy for you just to copy this whole bunch of files onto your website, and you can immediately test it. If you click on StatPlanet, you can see what the map looks like in a web browser, which is the same as in the application form. Here it is. And lastly, there is the StatPlanet small file, and this allows you to this is basically an example of what the interactive map looks like embedded inside an existing web page. So that's about it for how to create an interactive map in 5 minutes.